السلام عليكم. With you مروة محمد عبد الباقي Lecturer at Faculty of Nursing Minia University, Egypt. My specialty is critical care nursing. I am very happy to be with you at the 7th Nursing Conference, and I hope that everybody will be safe from COVID-19 infection to protect yourself and your families. Now I am going to discuss my article with you about the effectiveness of using breathing exercise on sleep quality among hospitalized patients. My colleague name, Iman Fadla Abdel Khaliq, Department of Medical Surgical Nursing, Faculty of Nursing, Minia University. Naglaa Ahmed Ahmed, Department of Critical Care and Nursing and Emergency, Faculty of Nursing, Asyut University. And Sahar Hamza Taha Morsi, Department of Medical Surgical Nursing, Faculty of Nursing, Minia University, Egypt. Sleep disturbance among hospitalized patients has many factors, especially at critical urgent. Daily breathing exercise, aspirated lip breathing, and diaphragmatic breathing improves sleep quality and reduce occurrence of delirium. It's widely documented that patients in ICU suffer from poor sleep with up to 61%, so that it's likely suspected that reducing sleep disturbance using breathing exercise could have a better effect on patients' outcome and will reduce delirium. Aim of this study is to evaluate the effectiveness of using breathing exercise on sleep quality among hospitalized patients. Quasi-experimental design using a purpose of sample, including 150 patients, were divided into four equal groups. Two groups from medical ward study and control, 38 patients each, and two from medical intensive care unit study and control, 38 patients each group. Also, they were taken from many university hospitals of Egypt. A post-study group at medical ward and the medical intensive care unit received health education about breathing exercise, aspirated lip breathing, and diaphragmatic breathing. Post-study groups from the different departments or units applied the breathing exercise 3 times per day. But the control groups were evaluated without using health education about the breathing exercise, and they didn't apply it during their stay at the ward or the intensive care unit. The following tool were used to evaluate the four groups at the medical ward or the intensive care unit. Three tools used for collecting data for this study. Tool one, patient health assessment questionnaire. Tool two include two parts, sleep quality questionnaire, and part two, factors affecting sleep quality assessment sheet. Tool three, Nilon and Schembingen confusion scale. Scale originally designed to detect delirium in hospitalized patients. Results. Majority of the groups were male, all patients were in middle age group, and it was observed that before applying a breathing exercise, 39% and 44.70% of the medical ward group had severe sleep problem, and 52.6% and 44.70% respectively of the medical intensive care unit groups had also severe sleep problems. The following figure presenting that percentage distribution of the factors that affect sleep quality among the studied group. It was observed that pain is one of the causes that lead to sleep disturbance among the four groups of the medical ward and the medical intensive care unit. And dyspnea, the third one is the procedure. Categorization according to priority or an arrangement according to priority, it was observed that procedure is the first leading cause of sleep disturbance among the medical ward and the medical intensive care units. Next, dyspnea and pain. But the other causes is GIT disturbance, lighting, noise, and stuff. All of these factors were the leading cause of sleep disturbance among hospitalized patients at a medical ward or the medical intensive care unit. The following table presents that percentage distribution of patients of post study and the control group in medical ward and the medical intensive care unit regarding Nilon and Schembingen confusion scale after applying breathing exercise. It was observed that 48.7% of the study group at the medical ward and 50% of the medical intensive care unit study group had great sleep quality. Also, majority of the study group's patients at the medical ward and the medical intensive care unit had no confusion, with percentage of 60.5% and 52.6%. The following figure presents that percentage of patients in post-study and the control group regarding patient sleep pattern during hospitalization after applying breathing exercise. It was observed that 82% of the study group at the medical ward had good sleep quality. On the other hand, only 10% of them had poor sleep quality. But the control group, only 30% of them had good sleep quality and 45% of them had poor sleep quality. But at the medical intensive care unit, it was observed that after applying breathing exercise also as a study group of the medical ward, it was observed that 75% of them, of the study group, had good sleep quality and only 15% of them had poor sleep quality. But the control group, only 20% of them had good sleep quality and 55% of them had poor sleep quality because they didn't receive any breathing exercise health education during their hospitalization. In conclusion, the following study concluded that breathing exercise had a significant effect on improving sleep quality and reduced the occurrence of delirium among the study and the control group in the medical ward and the medical intensive care unit. So I am advising everybody to assess the sleep quality of their patients and also apply breathing exercise and consider it as the routine nursing rule to be applied for every patient during their stay at the hospital to improve their oxygenation and improve their sleep quality in order to decrease the occurrence of delirium, which is one of the major side effects that affect our patients during their hospitalization. Thank you, everybody, and I hope you are going great and being safe from the COVID-19 infection. Thank you.